Well, welcome to yet another edition of our Good Company Roundtable Conversations, where we've had some incredible conversations this past year. And being that this is the month of November, there are some very key days that happen in this month. So we thought, let's talk about giving. As we just wrapped up Thanksgiving in Canada, we've got Thanksgiving coming up in the U.S. We have Remembrance Day, Black Friday, Giving Tuesday. So all of that just in November. Then we have Christmas coming up, where we have a lot of days all about giving. The joys of Christmas, right? So we're going to dive into the conversation with Origin and Care Baldwin. How are you guys doing today?
Awesome.
I love it. All right. Talking about the idea of giving. Why do we give? I have heard there are benefits in giving. Yes? No? Truth? Falsity?
I guess the question is really, is there actual health benefits in giving? A lot of people think that there's something that happens chemically in our bodies when we give. But I think you can also have that debate where you say, yeah, but I think just the fact that there's joy that we receive when we're the gift giver, we're getting something out of it. So I think that's good to give for many reasons. Yes, I think as believers, we want to put the focus on, you know, we're called to give to benefit, you know, man and to fulfill that purpose, to honor God. There's all kinds of things we could talk about. But I definitely think there is some personal health benefits to it. But maybe Origin, you have more to say on that.
Well, you kicked it off beautifully, if I do say so myself. But yeah, I really think the benefits of giving are multifaceted. Certainly there's that spiritual aspect that giving is a form of embodied worship. When we are choosing to acknowledge the gift of the things that we have, the privileges that we have materially or non-materially, and when we can choose to give those up as an act of kindness to others, as an act of saying, God, I give thanks for this and I don't need to cling to it. Right? I think there's a lot of spiritual and emotional benefits there. And speaking about like the kind of internal, like physiological side, I can't say that it's the same for everyone across the board. I think we all have different experiences, but for many of us, when we give from a place of that kindness, the connection to the person or the purpose we're giving to, connection to ourselves, totally. That can release some like oxytocin. It feels good in our bodies. It can help us to just feel like chemically and physiologically more safe, more relaxed, more connected to the world. Especially when there's that sense of meaning in when we're choosing to give, right? Whereas a lot of us maybe give from a place that wouldn't be as healthy or wouldn't give those benefits. If we're just anxious, like God is going to be like so ashamed of me unless I give. There's something wrong with me unless I give, right? If we're giving from that place, probably not going to have the same benefits. So it's important, I think, for us to ask, like, out of what spirit, out of what intention, out of what state of being am I choosing to give? I think determines the direction of the outcome.
I think it's so good that you even just worded it that way, because I'm thinking, Origin, of like tithing in your church. And I know this is not where we're bringing this conversation. Yeah. But as a worship leader, there's been times where from the, you know, the platform, I've had to put out that call. And like, it's such a strategy for churches and church leaders, especially heading into this really season of giving where we want to see donations increase, that sort of thing, where you have to be so careful about what your wording is, right? Like my pastor always says, we're blessed to be a blessing. Like, let's look at it that way rather than like, you know, you have to give, this is what we're called to do. Like, I mean, that's a tricky one for, I think, a lot of pastors to navigate and church leaders, but that's something that people are afraid to go into the church because they're afraid of being pressured into giving.
Because all of those little catchphrases too, God loves a cheerful giver. There's like this element of almost guilt attached to it. You know, I'm supposed to give my tithes and offerings. Okay. And it can be stressful for people, but I do love the Bible story where it talks about the lady who just gave just a couple little, I don't even know what they were.
Little copper coin or something.
Yeah. And these other guys were like, here's my entire purse of money. And Jesus was like, she gave so much more because she had so much less to give. Like, it was nice that they had a big chunk of change. It's going to help. I can use it. I'm not going to say no. But how she gave, her heart as she gave, was so much more appreciated. I use that term loosely because I'm sure God appreciates all of our giving, but it just meant more.
Yeah, I think that really highlights how significant our internal process is and what's happening in our context when we choose to give, because we compare that to like the rich young ruler, right? Mm-hmm. Who Jesus confronted him saying, all right, if you want to get into the kingdom of heaven, if you want to understand this way that I'm about, sell everything, give it all away, right? Yeah. And that was a roadblock he couldn't actually cross. So for him to give what he had out of all of that would be, I think one might argue, just as significant as that woman who just had a little bit. Yeah. Giving that. Yeah. Right? So I think it's a lot more about our heart posture and our context than it is about the amount.
Yeah. I just want to add to that too, because I remember hearing Andy Stanley do a whole series of podcasts on generosity. And he's talking about how you don't have to have much in order to start developing that habit and that lifestyle of generosity. So it's like young people, you know, I don't feel like I have any money. I don't have a job or whatever. Or even, you know, people who are just kind of living paycheck to paycheck. He's saying, just start with a small amount because you're developing that posture. You're developing that lifestyle, that habit, that attitude of generosity. And then, hey, you know, when you do have more to give, you're going to incrementally give more because you already understand the importance and the value of giving.
Absolutely. And we do live in a culture now where it's so much more me focused. Well, at least it was 19 months ago or 20 months ago now, where I feel like with the pandemic, and I hate to keep referencing it, but it was just so monumental. It was huge. It changed everything. We started seeing people, you know, starting Facebook pages of, if you have it, great. If you need it, let us know, you know, as ways of connecting and helping each other, and people dropping off food for someone who was in quarantine or family members were sick. And it's just been incredible seeing people give in a different kind of way over the past year and a half. And it's encouraging to see that shift. But yeah, we definitely live in that me culture. I mean, Black Friday's coming up. We know someone's going to be front and center looking for that TV at, you know, that big box store. It's like, what can I get? What can I get? And so I think giving helps combat or neutralize that side of just us and our nature.
Yeah, just thinking that I think it totally reorients how we engage with our world, how we engage with our material possessions, and how we engage with other people, when I think this all really overlaps what Kara was saying, right? The ongoing practice with little things of practicing like gratitude, I think that then translates into our readiness and openness to giving. And so certainly we live in this world that very much often is attached. Like, we attach our sense of self. We attach the stories about who we are and our success to how much we have or what we have or what people see that we have, right? And so I really think that there is something like healing to the soul and also healing to our world when we can, instead of just kind of going along and perpetuating that stuff, we can say, do I really need this? Mm-hmm. Why do I need this? Maybe I can do something different with my money instead of, you know, just splurging with the purchases on the days when all the sales are happening. But yeah, I think there's something really significant there.
Well, and you're talking about, you know, where do we put our worth or our status or our value? And I want to be the person that's known for putting my identity or my worth in what I do for others and what I give. I want that to be my reputation, right? Like Holly, you mentioned those buy nothing groups on social media that just exploded over the last year and a half. And a lot of it is not, hey, I have something that I don't need anymore. My junk is your treasure. But actually what had come out of it was that a lot of people were like, you know, I'm stuck at home. I had a surgery. I can't go get groceries. Is there anyone in the community that can help? You know, or like, hey, this kid down the street has been playing basketball 4 hours a day with no net. Can we pitch in and get the kid a net? You know, it's seeing the community come together and you're building this new perspective and this reputation of being a generous body and a generous people. And I think it's definitely holidays and times like these where commercialism is so much in the forefront that we need to be intentional about flipping that focus and be like, no, what do I want to be known for? What am I representing here? What do I want to actually inspire in others? Right? Like, I mean, we moved under a year ago and I'm at that point now where I'm trying to just purge some of the stuff that I just don't have room for.
Yeah.
And you know, a lot of times my mentality goes, you know, I paid a lot for this. Sure, I haven't used it in 8 years, but I'm gonna sell it on Kijiji rather than, there's a buy nothing group I'm on that I've actually benefited from myself. I would rather put this up on that group than try to, you know, dime people, you know, to try to get just something out of a commercialized or, you know, material item. That's not where our worth is. That's not what's important.
Hey, thanks for watching. Catch the full video of our roundtable discussion now on Faith Strong Today.